Shoppers race in to take advantage of huge sales at Master. Failed home improvement store Master's closing down sale has descended into chaos, with confusion reigning over the price of reduced stock and staff bearing the brunt of customer frustration. When Dick Smith had its closing down sale earlier this year, customers complained some staff were keeping the best items for themselves. Bargain hunters have now taken to the Master's Facebook page to complain about misleading advertising and absolutely disgusting customer service. 2 weeks into the chain's fire sale, which aimed to shift more than $500 million worth of stock by December, the Woolworths-owned retailer is struggling to maintain order. "I just went to pick up an order that I paid for and the item has not been in stock for a week," customer Andrea Angurius complained. False advertising. Master's not happy. The retailer's social media moderator replied with an apology and promised to investigate further. Other shoppers pointed out that the price of advertised sales stock was different in store. "Your catalog says 40% off blinds with the picture of the clear plastic cafe blinds. So my wife goes into the Ellenbrook store only to be told that the special is only on the mesh blinds." Quote, Shane Del Nero wrote, "Why put the picture off the cafe blinds? The woman who served her was very rude as well. False advertising at its best." Another disgruntled customer vowed to complain to Fair Trading after waiting 6 weeks for her order to receive just 40 of the 150 palings she'd ordered. "Would not shop at Masters again." Quote, Joe Bland wrote, "We were told would be no trouble. Still waiting and worst thing is no one gets back to us. Not a happy customer. You are closing cause your service sucks." Others complained that staff were not honoring the advertised price of rocker tiles and outdoor furniture. "Please at least have the respect not to put your staff in a position that they can't defend," Kayleen Pusey wrote. "Makes life for your staff even tougher when they are unable to sell at the advertised price and obviously customers very disgruntled, some who have driven quite some distance for the disappointment, also witnessed the poor kitchen staff having to keep explaining, "No more orders. Why don't you close the display down to avoid this and make some upfront advertising to make things clear?" A Master's staff member apologized and asked for further details. "Treat me like a human being." Staff member Renee Christina hit back, writing that she and her colleagues were just trying to do our best as we are coming closer to the end. "Since the fire sale has kicked in, we have been given new prices with little time to change tickets and new store policies to follow," she posted on Facebook. "I have been verbally abused, filmed so it can be put on social media as horrible service, and had to literally clean up someone's SHST in the public bathrooms at our store. I come to work with a smile on my face every time because I want to try and have a good day at work, even when I know I'm going to be treated like SHST. Since this sale, I have seen new customers coming in demanding better prices, saying it's my job to serve them and they have rights. I didn't know my job required me to deal with total holes. If you come in and treat me like a human being, then I would happily help and serve you, but treat me like SHST, then go help yourself. I'm not paid to deal with your abuse." Amid the complaints about poor service were some sympathetic posts in support of Masters. Soon-to-be jobless staff. "Must be soul-destroying to know that you will shortly be out of a job in today's job market." Quote, Derek Naismith wrote, "We only went to Masters a few times but found the service really good, streets ahead of Bunnings. But others were not so understanding. The staff are still getting paid a wage to go job and have some sort of professionalism, but it seems customer service is the first thing that seems to have been marked down. Quote, Aaron Hankel wrote, end of an era. Masters loyalist Sharon Richardson lamented the demise of the Bunnings competitor, arguing that consumers would be worse off. Maybe if the same people whinging about discounts had supported the Masters stores from the beginning, instead of still going to Bunnings, they would not be closing down. She said, now there will be no competition for Bunnings and they will more than likely go back to their old ways. Chris Galicia agreed, writing, have a look at electronic retailing. In 2010, you could go to Clive Peters, Retro Vision, Dick Smith and David Jones to buy a TV. Now all of these no longer exist and it's hard to get a discount greater than 20%. Masters said all warranties would be preserved under a new Woolworths-based scheme to be unveiled at a later date. Dana.McCauley at news.com.au